So yes, it is Thursday. We get our natural gas inventory numbers. I'm gonna jump in here, jump into our natural gas contract. Let's see where we're trading. Started off with maybe our new ones. Looking at the April contract. You got natural gas trading at 286. Quite a little run this morning from 281. Yeah, up to 286. Some cold hitting the country right now, maybe. Some cold hitting a little Florida in context of everything. Okay, so 286. I jumped to the noons first. We tend to like take a look at the noons. It gives us an hour and a half. We have 285 as a price point.
Oh, that's good.
Not bad, right? Yeah. So we'd have about a penny of intrinsic value to the bullish side. Here's your bullish spread. That's going to be the expensive one because you have some value plus premium. So you're looking at $19 to the bullish side. Of that 19, about 10 of that dollars is intrinsic value because you're trading at 286. And then on the bearish side, it's going to be all premium. No intrinsic, so you're just paying the 9 in premium. So you're looking at about $28. Call it 30 bucks that you need to make with commissions, a buck on each side.
Okay.
And you need about 3 pennies away from 285 before noon to get to kind of your break even on either side. Jumping around real quick, let's see where the 230s line up. Not really going to be a great option. We have 280 if you want really volatility on both sides, and the dailies, pretty similar to 280. Now just checking the 11 AMs. Because we saw what the noons were going to cost us, right? Here's your bullish spread, about 14. Your bearish spread, about 8. So 22, 23. You know, so you'd have to ask yourself, do I want to pay 2 pennies, maybe a little bit more than two pennies to have exposure to 11? Or do I want to pay maybe 3 pennies in total to have exposure, just to kind of generalize?
Oh, yeah.
And that's where, you know, you just pick up your market bias. So you know what? I don't let this thing ride between 10 and 11, maybe. Let's see what happens. It's quite a number for oil yesterday, right? Seven million barrel build, and the market shakes it off and trades higher.
And then it ended up in the negative.
Did it? Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so look at this is quite a move, man. Look at this chart. You know, this is...
What's amazing, too, this chart, this doesn't even include the craziness that happened going up to 410 and whatnot.
Yeah, so... This is not a bad looking chat. Let's go here. Can you bring that back?
Because yes.
Yeah, 280. That's saying to me that it wants to go higher.
So, higher, huh? Okay.
Yeah.
Now here's, you know, just so we did all, and what's nice here is that you do have the penny of intrinsic value on your side, right? So that's nice. You have a head start to the bullish side. Really, to break even, you only got to trade up, if you do the noon, 3 pennies. You got a penny head start.
Okay.
But we always look at just some of the directional. So, you know, that's just a straight volatility. But what if you just want to go directionally? Number one, you always have, you know, some of the noons, whereas you don't need to cover yourself on the bearish side if that's what you're doing.
Right.
You can just lock in the 18, right? Then you're basically buying it at 286.8.
Yeah.
The market's trading at 285.8. So you're paying 1 penny.
That's pretty cool.
For a risk reward of basically risking 1 to make 10.
Yeah.
That's now, you need a 20-cent run. You're not going to get a 20-cent run before noon to 305, all right? Not, you know, 999 times out of 1,000, you won't.
But you can.
And you could get a run up to 290 or 295.
Right.
For sure, before, depending on what happens. But the other side, too, if you want the dailies, and this is where it's not bad. We kind of dismiss them if it's a volatility trade. Excuse me, those are the noons. But if you're just entering it for a... directional trade, this is a great example. Now, you have risk all the way down to 280, which is a lot of risk.
That's a lot of risk.
It
is. Right.
But you can always trade out of this, too.
No, I know.
And you're getting in at 286.3.
I like the penny risk.
And the market's at 286. I just want to illustrate, you're paying 4 tenths of a penny here.
Yeah.
3 tenths of a penny here in premium. And you can trade out of it. So we'll see. 286, we get those numbers when we come back.
Stay right there, folks. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow Industrials right now down 276, NASDAQ up 75, S&P's down 24. Come right back. Welcome back, folks. Natural gas stockpiles fell 149 BCF. It's going to be interesting to see what happened here because that's what they were thinking, right?
Pretty close, right? Yeah. You had a Bloomberg survey, minus 150, median estimate, minus 145.
Yeah.
Jumping back to the charts. And no real reaction. We're sitting at 285.5. We're sitting at just about 286 coming into that number. That is a tiny bar in terms of when that number usually breaks. We usually see a knee jerk one way or the other, no matter what happens in terms of a penny, maybe 2 pennies. People sometimes, not that you pull your bid and your offer, right? But you make sure you know what news is going on before you just have your offer sitting out there. So you can see that market jump around
right
as those bids and offers right next to the market dry up just as they wait for that number as we do. 285.7, we'll check back in, but no real movement just yet. And that's why, you know, when you lock in some of these defined risks, you know, if you're not paying a lot of premium, that's the benefit that, you know, you get no movement, you're not really losing any money, right?
Right.
That's what you have to examine as these. But as we say, that ticking down, we're down about a penny, 285. We'll see what happens.